Hello, this presentation is going to discuss conditional probability and the multiplication rule. The notion of conditional probability is more intuitive if we just think of if-then statements. If something happens, then something else happens. And we're just going to be looking at the probability of that statement. So a conditional probability is the probability of an event occurring given that another event already occurred. So if we roll a 5 on a die, it's going to be an independent trial than if we roll the die a second time. That would be appropriate to classical probability. But if we pull cards from a deck and we don't return the card to the deck, we might say, what are the odds if we've already drawn an ace that we will draw another ace? And you know that if you don't return that ace to the deck, that there are now only 3 aces instead of 4. And so the probability is going to be lower. So just with that kind of intuition, we can move forward thinking about conditional probability. So if we have, here's an example of going back to poker chips. We have 5 red, 4 blue, and 6 white. 2 are randomly selected. What's the probability that the second chip is red, given that the first is blue, and that we don't return that blue chip to the stack of chips or the basket? So the first chip is selected and not replaced. There are 14 chips remaining. Therefore, the probability changes. It's 5 out of 14 instead of 5 out of 15, right? So that's the basic idea of conditional probability. Here's another example. We have 100 college students surveyed and asked how many hours a week they spent studying. Here are the results, broken out by gender, male and female. We have some that study less than 5, some 5 to 10, and some more than 10 hours. Over here, we've got the total for the male and female, and the total within each of the classes in terms of the number of hours spent studying. So we want to know what's the probability a student spent more than 10 hours studying, given that the student is a male. So there's male, and there's the number studying more than 10 hours, which is 16. We know there are 49 total males, so that's the sample space. And we therefore know it's 16 out of 49. Therefore, 0.327. Independent events are 2 events that happen independent of one another, such as rolling a die 2 separate times. So in that case, the occurrence of rolling the die 1 time will not influence a second roll of the die. And that's where perhaps gambler logic fools people. They think, oh, look, I've rolled the die and it's come up 5 2 times in a row. It's bound not to be a 5 next time. Not true. The probability is exactly the same with every roll of the die. Does not affect the probability of future events if they're independent. 2 events, A and B, are independent if, mathematically, we could put this way using this equation. Probability of B given A equals the probability of B, or if the probability of A given B equals the probability of A. Events that are not independent are what we call dependent. And that's where we get to the conditional. So we decide if the events are independent or dependent before we start calculating probabilities, because it's going to be a different kind of math. And we can go back to the example of pulling cards out of a deck of cards. If we have not pulled any cards yet, the chance of pulling a diamond is going to be a fourth of the deck, or 13. There are 13 diamonds in a deck of cards. And if we return the diamond to the pile, we're back to 52 cards. If we don't, then we've reduced the sample space, making it a dependent event. Right? If we're not returning cards to the deck, we're creating a dependent event for the second time we pull a card. So if we do put it back, then we know the probability of selecting a spade is the same. It's 13 out of 52. But if we keep it out, now it's 13 out of 51. We could also ask, what are the odds of drawing a diamond and then a spade in that particular order? And in that case, we'd have the probability of each separate event, but we'd multiply them. That's the multiplication rule. And that's stated here. The probability of 2 events, A and B, occurring in sequence is P A and B equals P A times P B given A. So if event A and B are independent, the rule can be simplified to simply P A and B equals P A times P B. So the probability then of drawing a diamond, which is 13 out of 52, followed by drawing a spade, which is 13 out of 51, is simply their product, which is 169 over 2652, which can be expressed as 0.064. Here's another example of the multiplication rule that involves separate types of events. So let's say we want to roll a die and toss a coin, two coins rather, and we want to know the probability of getting a 5 with the die followed by flipping two tails. Now, are those dependent or independent events? That's right, independent. What you roll on the die will have nothing to do with the result of flipping a coin, and what you get flipping a coin will have nothing to do with flipping a second coin, right? So those are all independent, and therefore we can just look at the individual probabilities of each of those independent events, and we can multiply them together. And so rolling a die, we know that's a 1 out of 6 probability, and flipping a coin, we know that's a 1 out of 2 probability. Take the product of those things, and you see that the probability of this happening is 1 out of 24, which can be expressed as 0.042.